started here, make sure your feet are about shoulder width apart. You're gonna take your arms up, breathing in and smiling, and then exhale, bring the arms down. We're gonna do that again. This time, bend the knees. We're gonna bring the arms up and make sure that your arms are about shoulder width apart. And we're gonna crescent moon to the left. So bending to the left. Nice and soft here. We're just waking it up. We're gonna come back to center right here. Last breath in, moving up and bringing the hands to the heart. At this moment, you wanna set your intention for your practice today, whatever that is for you. We're gonna take ourselves into our Warrior One pose. So I'm gonna bring the left leg forward, right leg back, and the arms are gonna rise over my head. Now, if you have shoulder issues, bring the arms down here. Be kind and listen to your body. Breathe in. And then exhale as you go into Warrior Two. Extend those fingers out. Make sure the knee is bent slightly and don't let it go over those toes. Nice breath here. Feel rooted and grounded. And we're gonna reverse that warrior. You're gonna take the hand to the back of your leg. Take the arm up and you can bring it to the ceiling. You can bring it down here. You can bring it to the back wall. Whatever you want today. Take a nice breath in, use your core, lift yourself up, have your hand on the top of your thigh, extend that arm out for that extended arm stretch. Nice breath in. And we're gonna open up into triangle. I'm gonna take my leg on the inside of my thigh, stretching down and all the way up. So glad you guys are here. We're gonna turn ourselves around. This is called flight pose right here. So I'm in a 45 degree, my hands are out as if I'm about to take flight here. Nice breath in. Bring the hands to chest in a prayer position right here. And this is where if you have a chair beside you, you'll grab the chair here. You're gonna bring that back leg up and you're gonna go into Warrior Three. So you're gonna extend the leg back, the belly button goes up, your arms are forward, or they're to your side, or they're right here. You do you today. Nice breath in. And as you exhale, bring that leg back down. I'm gonna face you here for our nice breath in. I want you to fold forward, ragdoll. Grab those elbows. Nice and slow here. And let your neck hang. You may want to just move it back and forth. And then very slowly, one vertebrae at a time, you're going to rise up. And another breath in. And exhale. You did it. Fantastic. Grab a sip of water. Stay nice and hydrated for me. And we're gonna go into our second round. We're gonna do those same moves, but we're gonna move to the other side. So I want your feet to be shoulder width apart. Wiggle those toes, feel nice and grounded. Take a nice deep breath in and just exhale. And close your eyes if you want. Take your wrist, roll them around in one direction and then the other direction. Rolling your shoulders. And we're gonna take our hands, rise up. And then exhale. Taking your hands up again. And exhale. This time you're gonna take your hands up and I want you to crescent moon now to the other side. And that might be your right if you were on your right before, or your left if you didn't do that side. That's the toughest part, remembering which side you did first. Take a nice deep breath in. We're gonna come back up. Use those obliques and core to lift yourself back up. Take a nice breath in. We're gonna go into our warrior one on the other side, hands to heart. And bring that foot now to the right. The other leg is back, and the arms are gonna come straight up overhead, gazing forward. That knee is pushing out a little bit. Don't let it go beyond those toes, though. We're gonna ease into warrior two, twisting our core, bringing the fingertips out, extending through those fingers. We're going to reverse that warrior. We're going to take the hand to the back of the leg. You can take your arm all the way up. You can bring it right here, or you can bring it straight. Take a nice deep breath in and exhale as you extend that arm forward, resting your right arm on that leg. Nice breath here. And then open up into that triangle. So that hand is going to come down the leg. You can be up here if you wish, right at the knee. You can come all the way down. The other arm is straight, and I'm looking forward. Or if you want to take it even further, you can look straight up. We're going to take our whole body now as you inhale. I want you to exhale as you twist and come into that flight position. My knees bent. And I'm going to bring my hands to my heart. Bring the back leg up, preparing for that warrior three. So I'm going to bring that core in, and I'm going to extend that leg up as I exhale. And as I said, you can bring your hands out here. They could be along your side. They could be right here at your heart. Nice breath in. Finding a place to focus and bringing that leg down. Shake out those hips if you need to. Coming back forward. I'm going to take my breath in again. And as I exhale, I'm going to fold forward into ragdoll, grabbing my elbows, decompressing the lower back one vertebrae at a time, and letting your head come comfortably in front of you. You can shake your head here if you need to. And as I exhale and let go, I'm going to come back up nice and slowly, one vertebrae at a time. And take the shoulders, roll them back and forward. I hope everyone's doing wonderful so far. And thank you again for being here. It's just great. I love to start off my day this way, and I also love to end my day this way too. So wherever you are in the world, just glad we're doing it together. All right, this is going to be our balancing sequence. So like I said, I'm going to grab this chair just because sometimes our balance does need to be recalibrated, as sometimes we're doing things or we're not getting enough sleep or our bodies might be overstressed. And also half of our body is sometimes more balanced than the other half. So the right might be a little different from the left. So make sure you have something to grab onto in case you need to. We're gonna take our shoulders. We're gonna roll them back. So open up the chest. I want you to breathe in, extending the arms out. And as you exhale, I want you to round your back, hug the tree. We're all tree huggers today. Bring the chin to your chest. And open up again. Love this song. Open up. And exhale. Okay, we're gonna find our tree pose. Now your tree might be here with your foot up. Your tree might be along your calf. Your tree might be along your thigh. Or you might fold up here. Wherever your tree is, make sure it's not on your knee. You wanna make sure that your knees stay nice and strong, so you don't wanna put it on anywhere of your kneecap. So find your tree. Put my tree up here. We're gonna lift our arms up. Now you can keep your arms lower here. And we're gonna balance here for just a little while. Take a nice breath in. I want you to find a place to focus. And feel the music and balance. This is good. Beautiful. Take the arms down. Exhale. Bring the foot comfortably down. Shake out the hips if you need to. We're going to go into that warrior three. If you're using that chair, you would extend the leg out here. You can use that for support if you extend one arm. Or, if you're adventurous, bring the leg back. I'll come forward this time. Holding it here. All right, we're gonna transition into our half moon. Take the chair if you need to. You're gonna take the right leg and it's gonna come out to the side. And the arm is going to come up. Now, if I'm have the chair, I can be here. I can be here if I want to take it a little bit deeper. Or if you've had a cup of coffee this morning, or you're just feeling a little bit sassy, you can come all the way down to the floor. Leg all the way up. Hold here. Arm nice and high. Breathe in. And as you exhale, come all the way back up and stretch up those hips. We're going back into tree, finding that tree, the other leg, and bringing the arms up. I breathe in here, I expand my spine right here. So I really want to feel hollow. This is that area that's holding everything above and below. So when I bring my shoulders up, extend my spine, and bring my navel in, I can balance a little bit better. And then I want you to come back down. Exhale. And breathing up. Beautiful. Now we're going to do the other side. I don't want you to be crooked today, so we're going to do one side and then the other side. So we're going to take the chair. I'm going to put it over here. And I'm going to bring my feet shoulder width apart. I like to do a nice little shoulder roll. Nice breath here. I'm going to find my tree on my other side. So I'm going to bring my leg to your calf, thigh. You can bring it all the way up, working on that hip flexibility here. I'll do that on this side. And then bring your hands wherever feels comfortable. If you're outside, you may even have a breezy tree. I'm gonna breathe right here. Beautiful. We're going to take that foot down, bring the arms down, take a nice deep breath in. We're going to go into that warrior three right here. So whatever foot you used, whether you're using your chair, bring the leg back. You want a nice line between the toe and your head, and the arms come out or to the side or to your chest. And focus. And bring the foot all the way down. Walk with the hips right here. We're gonna go into our half moon pose. So we're gonna take that leg out and the arm up. And you can be here if you're using a chair. Here. we're bringing it all the way down. Leg comes up. Nice deep breath in. Let your body mold into the position. And gently bring the foot down. Get nice and stable, bring your body back up. We're gonna go back into that tree pose. Nice breath here. And then as you exhale, bring the arms down and bring your leg down. Take a nice breath in. We're gonna fold forward. I'm gonna come over here so you can see. And we're gonna half lift, bring your hands up to your thighs, right above your knees, and then you're gonna take that knee out. Nice stretch here. And the other side as you exhale. Beautiful, you're gonna slowly roll up. And grab a sip of water. All right. I live in Arizona, for many of you who don't know, so it's, looking at the thermometer, over 100 degrees here. So staying hydrated is super important. And sometimes even when we don't feel thirsty, we still hydrate our body. All right, we're gonna come back to a standing position. And we're gonna do a few little power yoga exercises right now. So be ready, listen to your body, modify if you need to, stop if you need to. You're just here on your own journey, so just take it wherever it is for you. We're gonna lift our arms up and we're gonna sit back into chair pose. And when I do that, I bring my bottom back. I make sure my belly is tucked in and I lengthen my arms. So as if I'm sitting in a chair, it's a little squat pose here. And I'm gonna hold. Make sure those knees are not any further from your toes. And you're gonna come back up right here. You're gonna take that left leg and come out into a standing frog pose. So I'm gonna do a little squat here. Your squat can be wherever it's comfortable for you. And my hands are gonna be right here as I come down. Take a nice breath in. You wanna take this to a next level today. You can lift up your feet here. And exhale as you bring those feet down. So working on really a lot of strengthening of the lower body, also balance and control. We're gonna go up one more time, or you can just stay where you are. And I know your thighs are burning right now. Just a few more seconds, we're gonna open up into goddess pose. You will thank me later. And we're gonna lift up. Woo! I hope you were feeling that. Beautiful, shake it out. And we're gonna go on to our next section here. So our feet are gonna be shoulder width apart. Wiggle the toes, feel nice and grounded. Take a deep breath in, you're doing amazing. I'll have the next song start here. We're going to be working our way down to the floor. So once we get down there, we'll stay down there. I like to start standing up and then working our way down to the floor so we're not getting up and down, up and down, up and down. But that's just the flow. And we're going to be mixing it up. So tomorrow we're going to have something a little bit different. And on the last day, something really special for you too. So, all right, we're going to stare here. We're going to roll the shoulders. And we're gonna take ourselves into down dog. Now, if you're using your chair, you simply can just put your hands right here and bring yourself back. Or if you want to, you can get all the way down. It's like I'm forming a triangle with my body. Now your soles of your feet might not go all the way down to the floor, and that's okay. You can be on your toes. We're gonna bring the knee in. Take a nice deep breath and exhale. We're gonna lift our left leg into three-legged dog here. Take the left leg all the way up where you can. Nice stretch here. Beautiful. And with your next breath, you're gonna bring the knee into the chest. Little core work here, building some fire. That's a good thing. And we're gonna exhale as we bring that foot back out. And then we're gonna fold into pigeon right here. So we're gonna bring the leg forward. I'm gonna lay it down on the floor. And I'm gonna extend the back leg back. Now, if your back leg has to bend, totally cool. Be wherever you are today. Your forward leg might not come into an L shape. It might just bend slightly. You're gonna say, you're gonna thank me with this motion. And if you can, you should feel that stretch right about here. And if you want to, you can start bringing your body forward. And if you want to, you can take it all the way down. Lay that forehead down and just take a few moments to breathe. And with the next breath, I want you to slowly bring your body up. Use your hands. Now you can stay right here for a moment, or if you want to take your practice a little bit further, you can take that back leg, bend it up, come around, grabbing your ankle. And this would be a level two. To take it even further, you can take that arm up, extend it all the way around, and complete the circle. And when you're ready, you can let go. But staying straight in this pigeon pose is perfectly good too. Take a nice deep breath in here. We're gonna come on all fours and cat-cow. When we cat, we round our back, chin to chest, nice breath in. And then exhale, belly button to the floor. Bring that bottom and chest out. Let's do that one more time in your own rhythm. Rounding the back. And exhale. Okay, we've got the other side to do, so come back up into down dog. I'm gonna switch positions so you can see me here. And back into that down dog here. Nice breath here. And bring the knees in. Just feeling the rhythm of the music. And take the other leg up into three-legged dog. Make sure that your ears are aligned with your elbows. Take the knee into your chest. Bring a little fire to the party today. Hold it up here, you can do it. And with the next breath, exhale. Extend it back out. And here's the moment you've been waiting for. We're gonna bring that knee in and down into the pigeon. This is your aha moment. Thank you. And exhale. You can bring your arms forward. You can stay up here if you wish, if this is good and this is what your body's saying is good for you today. Or take it all the way down. We're gonna take a few breaths here. Thank you. And with the next breath, we're going to bring that back up. Walk the hands up. Bend the back leg if you wish, or you can stay right here. You can hold right here if this is where you're comfortable. Or you can take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, round yourself. Hold. And gently let go. Beautiful. Coming into tabletop. Cat-cow, chin to chest. And exhale out. Chin to chest. And exhale. Take a child's pose here. Decompress the lower back, extend your arms. Now this is an active pose, but it is a resting pose, but your body's really working. If you need to widen the knees, you can. And just let your body exhale as you breathe into this pose. Forehead down and in child's pose just for a moment. Beautiful. On the next breath, you're going to come back up to tabletop right here. And we're going to extend the leg and extend the arm. So this is really about the core right here. We're strengthening the core, but we're also working on other parts of your body. It's about focus and balance. So find that space in front of you that you want to focus on. I'm going to take first my right leg back. Make sure I don't hit the chair there. You can do the same motion on the chair. You'll do the same position. You'll just do it with one hand holding onto the chair. I'm going to extend the opposite arm. So once I feel stable here, and I do bring that belly button in, my leg up, and as soon as I feel stable, then I take that arm and I extend it out. Now the idea here is you don't want to twist then your hips. You want to keep them really aligned with the floor. That's the challenging part right here. Make sure that it's opposite foot to opposite hand. We're going to extend that out. Nice deep breath in and hold. Feeling it yet? Just a little longer. You got it. Beautiful. Now can you bring the knee into the elbow as you exhale? Slow and controlled. And then extend it out. Nice breath in as I extend my body. And then I'm going to exhale. Bring the knee and your hand back into tabletop pose right here. I'm going to do the child's pose, and I'm going to do a move called threading the needle. And when I thread the needle, my arm goes underneath. I'm going to be really opening up that shoulder. You're going to feel that in your, between your shoulder blades. I'm going to lay my body down. Hopefully you can see me. My camera angle's a little bit off, but I'm going to rest here. So I'm in a child's pose, but then my arm is crossing underneath. And I'm threading that needle. We're just going to breathe here. And I'm going to unthread right here. So I'm going to come back up to that tabletop. Cat-cow. We've done it before, so use your own breath and rhythm. Breathe in and exhale. Breathing in and exhale. And we're going to do that extended arm and leg pose again, just the opposite side. So you're going to take that leg, extend it out. Make sure you find a good position. You're nice and stable. Bring in the belly button. And then you're going to extend the arm out. I love this song, the way that it says listen. We have to listen more to our bodies. They're always speaking us to us, telling us a lot of truths. A little longer here. Bring the elbow in. Tap the knee if you can. Slow and controlled. We're gonna exhale. There we go. And we're gonna bring that down. I'm gonna switch sides so you can see me here. And we're gonna thread the needle on the other side. So I'm gonna extend back into that child's pose, taking my arm, putting it underneath my other arm as I lay my body closer to the ground, as far as we're comfortable. And just take a breath here. Breath, you're going to come back in and back up to tabletop right here. Cat cow, one of my favorite stretches. And if you have lower back issues, this one is amazing. You can do it with a chair. It really helps to relieve, especially if you have a job where you're sitting a lot. And exhale. Back into child's. Take a breath in. And we're gonna carefully come back up. Grab a sip of water if you need to. We're gonna turn ourselves around so we're already on the ground. So we're gonna stay down here for the rest of class. Do a little R&R. And a little stretch as we want to keep our joints nice and mobile. My philosophy is that nature is constantly in motion and we are a part of nature. So we need to also keep our bodies and minds in motion to stay healthy. So we're going to have our feet facing forward. Do the side so you can see me. This is called staff pose. It's probably one of my hardest poses because it's a pose where we have to stay very still, which is not easy for me to do, but that's why I practice every day. So our back is straight and I'm gonna bring my hands to the side. I'm gonna lift my spine right here in the shoulder. Now my feet, my toes are pointed up, my legs are straight, and I just wanna face forward, kind of extend my body longwise, in length and in height. Breathe here. I'm going to take my breath in and I want you to extend your body forward. So as far as what's comfortable, you might be able to grab your toes. You might be able to grab the space beyond your toes wherever you are. You might be able to bring your head all the way down, but wherever you are today, you're going to fold that forward. And then you're going to take a next breath in. Coming up, I want you to take the right leg. I want you to bring it over the left. We're going to do what is called a seated twist. So I have one leg that's straight, one leg that's bent. I'm going to turn towards the outer side of my thigh. So I'm going to take a breath in. My hand can be behind me. And I'm going to take my other hand. Now you can hold on to your calf as you twist. You can put your elbow right here as you twist, whatever's comfortable. Sometimes it pulls the leg just a little bit to give you an added stretch. So I want you to inhale and then exhale as you twist. I see someone's brave to have their camera on. Nice breath here. And we're going to exhale, turn your body back to center, extend that foot out. We're going to do the other side. I'm going to turn here so I'm not facing away from you. Bringing the leg over the other leg. Try to keep those toes up. I'm going to bring my elbow to my knee as I twist my body. My hand is going to come behind me and take a nice breath in. Fine. Nice breath here. Oh. Love to see everyone in the room. And exhale, you're gonna turn your body back to a seated position. We're gonna take it a little back. So I'd like you to bring your spine and your bottom until you're about in that tipping pose. You're not quite all the way down, you're not quite all the way up. So I'm really tilted right here. Now, if you want, you can bring both of your feet bow up. This is a half boat. You can have 1 foot down and 1 foot up. The other side, you can have both feet up. You can extend your feet all the way forward. We're gonna do the boat pose. So this is all core. If you shake, that's a good thing. It means you're working. So I want you to find your boat. Your arms are to your side. You're gonna find that space right here where you're just gonna start feeling that fire right here. I want you to take 5 little breaths here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And bring the knees in. Take a nice breath here. All right. You deserve to roll all the way back. Did a great job today. 1 vertebrae at a time, so still working that core. Not done yet. And I want you to come all the way down. So you're laying all the way on your back. Extend the legs out. Extend the arms overhead as well. So elongate yourself. And I want you to wiggle your fingers and toes, stretch out, and take a nice deep breath in. Just breathe here for a moment. Beautiful. Now, if you want to, this moment, this is our last position of the day, you can put your hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. I want you to connect your breath to your body right now, cultivating the spirit, the body, and the mind. So I want you to do a 3-point belly breath, which is where you breathe in and really feel the depth of the breath going to your belly rather than the shallow breathing we often do with our chest. And then as you exhale, I want you to slowly exhale all the air out. And I do this with a count, so I usually breathe in for 3, and I'll hold for 4, and then I'll exhale for 5. So for the rest of the song, I just want you to be present, let your thoughts drift in and out like clouds, feel your breath. Each breath, I want you to fill yourself with health. I want you to fill yourself with light. You are light. Fill yourself with joy and be present. And as you exhale, you can bring your hands to the side. You can roll over to your side. I usually just stay here for a moment. And when you're ready, you can use your hands to slowly come back up. Let your blood gradually get to all its needed organs. You don't have a head rush. And you can come to a seated position, lotus position, half lotus, easy pose, whatever you feel. Take a nice deep breath in here. Hands to heart as you exhale. One more breath in. And bringing the hands down to heart. I want to thank you so much for taking this time for you. Most important thing, rejuvenating yourself so that you can give more to others, because that's what it's about, right? We're all here to give back. We're all here to pay it forward. One of my favorite things to do in the whole universe. And it starts with taking care of you. So my message is to you today, and I want to have a share a nice message to take you into your dreams or take you into your day, is listen to the musical notes of the universe. And that universe starts within you. So thank you for taking care of you.